The Eastern African Power Pool is a 13-member association established in 2005 with the aim of alleviating energy poverty among member countries. However, the actual trading of electricity between members under the pool had not commenced since then owing to absence of key frameworks and agreements that have to be put in place.
It's been in existence for 18 years, yet regional power trade remains well below potential, much lower than in sister power pools, the SAP and the Western African Power Pool. However, major cross-border transmission investments over the last decade have just started to come to fruition, and the time is now to put in place enabling institutions, frameworks to accrue benefits from these infrastructure investments.
Ruth Nankabira, the chairperson of the Council of Ministers, outlined their next steps towards realization of the power pool.
The last one on the legal side is the establishment of transmission pricing methodology and wheeling agreements. All these have to be looked at by either our attorneys general or some kind of procedure. Colleagues, feel free to propose where you are not comfortable, because the East African Power Pool is based on consensus. We have to build.
The members are expected to meet in June to iron out the final details of the frameworks to enable operationalization of the power pool by 2024.
Yes, we are looking to complete the transmission line from Isinya to Namanga, so that last year when we had issues, when Tanzania had issues with the power and they were load shedding, then they can benefit from Ethiopia to Kenya and Kenya to Tanzania. Basically, what we are saying is, Africa, we have been operating in silos. It is high time we stop operating in silos and we build on each other and each other's capacities, such that we build one cohesive Africa that is going to be industrialized for the benefit of our people.
The power pool members boast of a total installed generation capacity of about 90,000 megawatts that has been accumulated over the last 18 years against a peak system demand of 54,000 megawatts. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.